In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. All praises and thanks are due to Allah, the Lord, the Rabb of Al-Alameen. Al-Alameen, as we know, jinn, mankind and all that exists. In continuity of the response of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah to the bishop's letter, we are still with the Shaykh where he is laying the foundation of his introduction. And we reached the point where he was speaking about al-hulul wal-ittihad, incarnation and unification. And he explained that this is composed of two kinds. مَا سَمَّاهُ الْعَامْ وَالْخَاصْ. Al-'am, the more general form of it is كَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ بِذَاتِهِ حَالٌ فِي كُلِّ مَكَانٍ أَوْ أَنَّ وُجُودَهُ عَيْنْ مَوْجُودٍ أَوْ عَيْنْ وُجُودِ الْمَخْلُوقَةِ. The general type is like those who say that Allah in himself exists everywhere and in everything. Like saying that he is the essence of all that exists, meaning that all that exists is Allah. تَعَالَ اللَّهُ عَمَّا يَقُولُونَ عُلُوًا كَبِيرًا. Allah is far above what they attribute to him. And that everything that exists is Allah. And the more special form of it is al-khas. والذي قال عنه الشيخ كالذين يقولون بالحلول والاتحاد على بعض أهل البيت وغيره مثل النصيرية والدرزية إلى آخره. And the more particular form of it is like saying is that which is said by some of them who say that incarnation and unification have touched some people of Ahlul Bayt or certain sheikhs or certain scholars, etc. As we discussed with the groups of the Druze and Nusayriya, and we gave some history about that, isn't it? You remember that now? You have notes on it, inshallah. ثم يقول فمن قال إن الله سبحانه وتعالى حل أو اتحد بأحد من الصحابة أو المشايخ فهذا وجه ضلاله أو وجه كفره أكبر من كفر النصارى. He says that those who claim such claims, their degree of kufr is more profound than that of the Nasara. And those who say and adopt the general form of incarnation and ittihad is also their belief is worse than that of the Nasara. Then we come to the point which he was going to emphasize in his book, in his introduction, and it says, فَبِمَعْرِفَةِ دِينِ النَّصَارَى وَبُطْلَانِهِ يُعْرَفُ بِهِ بُطْلَانِ مَا يُشْبِهْ أَقْوَالَهُمْ مِنْ أَقْوَالِ أَهْلِ الْإِلْحَادِ وَالْبِدَعِ فَإِذَا جَاءَ نُورُ الْإِيمَانِ وَالْقُرْآنِ أَزْهَقَ اللَّهُ بِهِ مَنْ خَالَفَهُ كما قال تعالى وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا. So when you know, when the knowledge about the deen, the religion of al-Nasara is made clear and its falsehood appears and also becomes clear, then it is easy to make contrast with what those innovators say and expose their forms of innovation as well. And when the light of Allah, which is the Quran, comes, this light overtakes and prevails over falsehood. The translation of the meaning of the ayah, which is in Surah Al-Isra, Surah 17, ayah 18, ayah 81, truth has come, and batil, which is falsehood, has vanished. Surely batil is ever bound to vanish. يقول مؤكدا وكان من أسباب نصر الدين وظهوره أن كتابا ورد من قبرك فيه الاحتجاج لدين النصارى بما يحتج به علماء دينهم وفضلاء ملتهم قديما وحديثا من الحجج السمعية والعقلية، وما ذكروه في هذا الكتاب هو عمدتهم، فإن هذه الرسالة وجدناهم يعتمرون بها أو يتبعونها قبل ذلك، ويتناقلها علماؤهم بينهم، والنسخ بها موجودة قديمة وهي مضافة إلى بولس الراهب أسقف مدينة بيضاء. Remember when he was discussing the point how the deen prevails when its opposition appears. When there is an opposition to the deen, right, this becomes a motivation for the prevalence of Islam and of the truth. So he said one of those causes which leads or which led to the zuhur of a deen, the prevalence of a deen, and the truth, in this case, this letter that came from this bishop of Sidon, in which it illustrates the creed of the Christians before and at his time. And this name, the name of the letter was الكتاب المنطقي الدولي أو الدولة خامي المبرهن عن الاعتقاد والصحيح والرأي المستقيم. هذه this is the title of the letter. It is the logical book of the great chief proving the correct belief as well as the correct opinion of the Nasara. This is the title of the letter. And he said, by the will of Allah, we will prove the invalidity of their claims, as well as we will touch upon each one of them in detail, proving such a goal. He says, أكثر ما عندهم من الحجج معظمها إن لم يكن كلها ألفاظ متشابهة. As we said, you know what is متشابه now? متشابه is the thing which is, he says that most of what they got is ألفاظ متشابهة, meaning not entirely clear, and they base their reasoning all on this not so clear foundation. He says, وَهَذَا حَالُ أَهْلِ الْبَاطِلِ. This is the situation with all the people who follow falsehood. And his evidence from the Quran, كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَ فِيهِمْ إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ وَمَا تَهْوَى الْأَنْفُسُ وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمُ الْهُدَى. In Surah Al-Najm, Surah Ayah 23, Ayah 23 and Surah 53, إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ. They follow what they get, and that which they themselves desire, whereas there has surely come to them the guidance from Allah. And then the saying of Allah, مستشهدا بقوله تعالى, وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا. ليعذب الله المنافقين والمنافقات والمشركين والمشركات ويتوب الله على المؤمنين والمؤمنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. In Surah Al-Ahzab, Surah 33, Ayat 72 and 73. And the translation of the meaning is that indeed man have taken the responsibility of carrying the message itself, the message, and verily man has been unjust to himself and had done wrong to himself. But then he says in the tafsir of this ayah, this is the beautiful tafsir that he gave, فالمؤمنون الذين تاب الله عليهم من الجهل والظلم. انتبه. حملها الانسان ان الانسان كان ايش؟ ظلما جهولا. ليعذب الله. طيب. فالمؤمنون الذين تاب الله عليهم من الجهل والظلم. انتبه. شوف هذه this is the beauty of the understanding of the Quran by شيخ الاسلام رحمه الله. فقال he says the believers are the ones whom Allah سبحانه وتعالى had bestowed with repentance upon them and safeguarded them from jahil and from zulm, from ignorance and from being unjust to themselves. And who are they? فيبين ايضا من هم هؤلاء المؤمنين والمؤمنات. هم اتباع الانبياء عليهم السلام. رياض صلى الله عليه وسلم رفض عليهم السلام. فان الانبياء انتبه فان الانبياء بعثوا بالعلم والعدل. شفت الاول الكلام كله اللي كنا نركز عليه قضية ايش انه فرق انه الانبياء واتباعهم معهم العلم والعدل والمعارضين لهم معهم الجهل والظلم. والان سيبين لنا شيخ الاسلام ما معنى العدل. The followers of the prophet are the ones who are safeguarded from these two, from the ignorance and from injustice. لان الانبياء because the prophet were sent with knowledge and justice. كما قال تعالى والنجم إذا هوى ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. By the star it goes down, as it goes down or vanishes. Your companion, meaning Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, has neither gone astray nor has he erred. It is only, it's only an inspiration that he was inspired. هذه سورة النجم. سورة النجم آية 1 and up till آية 4. So, clearly this ayah يبين سبحانه وتعالى عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه إيه؟ ليس ضالا ولا جاهلا. That he is not astray, is not following the astray path, neither himself is an ignorant. ولا غاويا متبعا هوا, and that he is not a follower of his own desire. ولا ينطق عن هوا, and he doesn't speak of his own. إنما أنطقه الذي أوحاه. The one who inspired him, made him speak the truth. كما قال تعالى وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. شوف الاستشهادات العظيمة هذه والاستنباطات الفائدة فيها ممتازة جدا لأن نتعلمها. قول هناك أول من العلم والعدل. شوف الآية المستشهد فيها يس وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب. And we have sent down with them what? Brought down with them what? الكتاب. What is الكتاب? الكتاب is الوحي, is the revelation, and all the revelation is knowledge. All the revelation is علم, knowledge, as well as والميزان. ميزان for what? The balance for what? For justice. ليقوم الناس بالقسط. So that mankind establish justice. وأصل العدل. طيب نسأل السؤال, ما هو أصل العدل عند الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أخوان؟ What is the basis? What is العدل for Allah? ما هو العدل لله عز وجل؟ حديثة رمعي. What is العدل to Allah? هذا جانب محدود, في جانب أوسع وأعم. هذا عدل حق لكن ما زال محدود بإذن العام والأصل. الله أكبر, هذا هو العدل. العدل عدم الشرك, العدل هو التوحيد. هذا العدل لله عز وجل. فإن الشرك وأصل العدل, يقول شيخ الإسلام, وأصل العدل العدل في حق الله كما بين الأخ من نص الحديث حديث معاذ رضي الله عنه. فالأصل the foundation of عدل is the عدل is the right of Allah سبحانه وتعالى وهو عبادته وحده لا شريك له. فإن الشرك إيه؟ ظلم عظيم كما قال تعالى يا بني على لسان لقمان لابنه يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. As this is defined and made clear by the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the tongue of Luqman to his son, O my son, do not commit and set partners with Allah, don't set up partners and rivals besides Allah. Verily إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. Verily shirk is a grave injustice. لما كان اتباع الأنبياء ولما كان أتباع الأنبياء هم أهل العلم والعدل, كان سلام أهل الإسلام والسنة مع الكفار وأهل البدع بماذا؟ بالعلم والعدل. بالعلم والعدل, لا بالظن ولا بما تهوى الأنفس.
He said, since this is the foundation for those who follow the Prophet's ways, and it is al-ilm wal-adl, let's speak them in Arabic now so that you know what they mean. Now you know what they mean, right? Al-ilm wal-adl, knowledge and justice. كان كلام أهل الإسلام. Then the speech of Ahl al-Islam with the kuffar has to be based on these two principles, al-ilm wal-adl, and not desire and guesses and following one own opinion. مفهوم يا اخوان؟ العلم والعدل مع الكفار ومع المبتدعة. قال تعالى دلالة على العلم: لقد ارسلنا رسلنا بالبينات. And indeed we have sent our messengers with what? بالبينات. With the proof. With the clear proof, which is based upon knowledge. ثم يقول أصل ما كفرت به النصارى واليهود أمران: تبديل وتكذيب. تبديل وتكذيب. The two basics upon which the kuffar established their belief, the belief of kufr, are two. Number one, denial. And then alteration, or alteration and denial. And this is the case with the Christians and the Jews. يقول وذلك أن دين النصارى إنما هو دين مبتدع ابتدعوه بعد المسيح عليه السلام. That's because the deen, the religion of the Nasara, of the Christians, is an innovative one, which they innovated after عيسى عليه السلام. وغيروا دين المسيح and altered the religion of عيسى. فيقول فضل منهم من عدل عن شريعة المسيح. Those who followed other than the legislation and the laws of عيسى عليه السلام, they erred and they gone astray. إلى ماذا؟ إلى ما ابتدعوه من عندي. They followed what they have innovated, what they have established. ثم لما بعث الله محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the message of the Quran, kafaru bih. They disbelieved in him. فصار كفرهم وضلالهم من هذا الوجهين. أولا بعيسى إيش؟ تبديل. صح؟ ثم بعد ذلك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إيش؟ تكذيب. In the beginning with عيسى عليه السلام, they altered, they changed. And then with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and with the advent of his message, they denied it and rejected it. تبديل دين الرسول الأول وتكذيب الرسول الثاني. Altering the messenger, the first messenger to them, in that case was عيسى عليه السلام, and then denying the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم as the second messenger. وكما كان كفر اليهود, and similarly the كفر of اليهود, وتبديلهم أحكام التوراة قبل بذعة المسيح, ثم تكذيبهم بمين؟ بعيسى بالمسيح أيضا. Similarly, the Jews committed the same thing, altering the laws in the Torah and the commandments, and then denying Isa's message عليه وعلى موسى السلام. ويقول ونبين إن شاء الله أن ما عليه النصارى من التثليث والاتحاد لم يدل عليه شيء من كتب الله, لا الإنجيل ولا غيره, بل دلت على نقيض ذلك. ثم التكذيب لمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو كفرهم المعلوم لكل مسلم, مثل كفر اليهود بالمسيح عليه السلام وأبلغ. He said, inshallah, we will make it clear that the deen of Nasara, the religion of Nasara, and the creed of Trinity as well, and the creed of unification and incarnation, that there is no evidence for that in the books of Allah, not even in the Injil, the Gospel, or nowadays they refer to it, the famous one that they refer to as the Bible. But the Bible that they had, or they have now, indeed had injected these principles and made them as the creed that to be followed. And those who descended when the concept of Trinity was declared by the Pauline Church, the follower of the Paul doctrine, were killed and persecuted. ويقول ولا غيره, يعني ما في حتى في أي كتاب آخر سماوي دلائل على هذا. There is no other book revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that contains any of such creed. Then we will show their takfir, their denial of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَهُمْ يُبَالِغُونَ فِي تَكْفِيرِ الْيَهُودِ انتبه لهذه النقطة. They over exaggerate in the in declaring the kufr of the Jews. بأعظم مما يستحقه اليهود من التكفير. More than the Jews deserve. إذ كان اليهود يزعمون أن المسيح ساحر كذاب، بل يقولون إنه ولدغية أي زينة، كما أخبر الله عنهم بقوله وقولهم على مريم بهتانا عظيما. The Jews were uttering words charging that Isa عليه السلام was just a magician and that he was a son of a an illegitimate child, quote unquote. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made clear in his book that this is one of their lies on Isa alayhi salam by saying وَقَوْلِهِمْ عَلَى مَرْيَمَ بُهْتَانًا عَظِيمًا and uttering against Maryam, Mary, a grave false charge. As in Surah An-Nisa, which is Surah 4, Ayah 156. وَالنَّصَارَ يَدَّعُونَ and the Christians claim أَنَّهُ اللَّهُ that he is Allah, that he is Allah himself. الذي خلق الأولين والآخرين that he is Allah who created the first generation and the latter one. وأنه ديان يوم الدين that everyone has to appear on the day of recompense appear before him. فكانت الأمتان فيه على غاية التناقض. The two nations, the Jewish and the Christian, were on opposing extremes regarding Isa عليه السلام. ولهذا كل أمة تذم الأخرى بأكثر مما تستحق مستشهدا بقوله تعالى وقالت اليهود ليست النصارى على شيء وقالت النصارى ليست اليهود على شيء وهم يتلون الكتاب. كذلك قال الذين لا يعلمون مثل قولهم فالله يحكم بينهم يوم القيامة فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون. In سورة البقرة, this is made clear by Allah in سورة البقرة, سورة آية 113. The Jews said that the Christians follow nothing. That is, they are not on the right path. They are not on the right religion. And the Christians said that the Jews follow also nothing. That the Jews themselves are not following the right religion. Though they both recite the script. مع أنهم يكتبون يعني الكتاب. Like unto their word said also who المشركين the pagan who know not. Allah will judge between them on the day of resurrection about wherein they were the things that they were in differing. سورة البقرة we said آية 113. فاليهود كذبوا بدين النصارى وقالوا ليسوا على شيء. والنصارى كذبوا بجميع ما تميز به اليهود عنهم حتى في شرائع التوراة والتي لم ينسخها المسيح بل امرهم بالعمل بها. شوف لحد وين التكذيب وصل. انتبه, يعني بقي هناك نصوص لم ينسخها دين عيسى عليه السلام, مع هذا النصارى كذبت فيها تماما لرفض اتباع اليهود باي شيء. So the Jews denied and rejected the deen, the religion of the Nasara, and similarly the Christians did. Not only that, the laws and the texts that were not abrogated by the message of Isa, those same texts were denied also by who? By the Christians. Those were found in the Torah. With the message of Isa alayhi salam, things were abrogated and things were not abrogated. They denied even the things which that were not abrogated, just to deny that the Jews are on anything, meaning not following the right religion. يقول فلا ريب أن اليهود لما كذبوا المسيح صاروا كفارا أيضا. Similarly the Jews, when they denied عيسى عليه السلام, they themselves also became كفار. كما قال تعالى على وإذ قال عيسى ابن مريم للحواريين, أو كما قال عيسى ابن مريم للحواريين من أنصاري إلى الله.
قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله، فآمنت طائفة من بني إسرائيل وكفرت طائفة، فأيدنا الذين آمنوا على عدوهم فأصبحوا ظاهرين. هذه سورة الصف آية 30. When عيسى عليه السلام spoke to the disciples asking them, من أنصار إلى الله؟ Who amongst you are going to be the supporters and helpers in the cause of Allah, helping me in the cause of Allah? قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله. We are the ones supporting Allah, means supporting Allah's religion. فآمن الطائفة من بني إسرائيل, a group of the children of Israel, and believe. And another one, however, disbelieved. فأيدنا الذين آمنوا, and we gave their support, the support to those who believed, فأصبحوا ظاهرين. They became the prevalent one. وكفر النصارى بتكذيب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وبمخالفة المسلمين أعظم من كفر اليهود بمجرد تكذيب المسيح. فإن المسيح لم ينسخ من شرع التوراة إلا قليلا. انتبه. يقول, شوف الاستنتاج الطيب هذا. يقول كفر النصارى, the disbelief of the Christian is more profound than that of the Jews vis-a-vis عيسى, نسبة لمن؟ لكفره بعيسى. Why? Because عيسى عليه السلام, the message of عيسى, the religion of عيسى, did not abrogate much of the Torah. Much of it remains. ويقول وسائر شرعه إحالة على التوراة. Most of عيسى's message and laws makes a reference to what? التوراة before. ولكن عامة دين النصارى أحدثوه بعد المسيح. But most of the religion of the Christians was invented by the Christians after عيسى عليه السلام. قال تعالى مبينا أن القرآن, شوف in this reference now, the Quran with respect to these two categories, the religious, the denial of the Jews and the Christians vis-a-vis each other, يقول الكتاب القرآن مستقل لم يحل شيئا منه على غيره من قبله. عرفنا؟ القرآن مستقل. The Quran is totally independent. It doesn't refer anything to any of the scriptures before it. عرفنا؟ Complete. Independently complete. قال تعالى أولم يكفهم أنا أنزلنا عليك الكتاب يتلى عليهم إن في ذلك لرحمة وذكرى لقوم يؤمنون. في قوله تعالى في سورة العنكبوت, في سورة 29 آية 51, Is it not sufficient for them that we have sent down to you the book, the Quran? Is it not sufficient, which means it is sufficient, which is recited to them verily herein or therein in the Quran is a mercy and reminder or admonition for a people who believe. ويقول والقرآن أصل كالتوراة وإن كان أعظم منها. And the Quran is an original as the Torah, though it is what? أعظم منها. It's greater in its comprehensibility and also in its perfectness. ولهذا يقول علماء النصارى يقرنون بين عيسى أو بين موسى ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The people of knowledge within the Christian always try to make resemblance or always they make resemblance always between whom? Between Muhammad عليه السلام صلى الله عليه وسلم وموسى عليه السلام. وأين الحادثة في مثل هذا؟ من يذكر حادثة؟ Who can remember an incident in which this point is illustrated? Anybody?
عرفتم يا اخوان النصف بالعربية؟ يعني انه عادة يقول شيخ الاسلام بهذا علماء النصارى يقرنون بين موسى ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
محمد
احنا بدنا حادثة من واحد من يعني اكابر النصارى او معروف لدى النصارى يعني جمل هذا الامر او جمعه. طيب يقول شيخ الاسلام كما قال النجاشي ملك النصارى لما سمع القرآن ان هذا والذي جاء به موسى يخرج من مشكاة واحد. He says the evidence that he cited. As the Najashi is a title of a king of Abyssinia, Al-Habasha. Okay. At the time of the Prophet ﷺ, when a group of the Muslims were persecuted and they migrated from Mecca, it was the early Hijrah, remember? They went to Al-Najashi. When he heard the Quran being recited to him, and the Najashi was a Christian himself then, and a king, he said, إِنَّ هَذَا Verily indeed, this Quran, what I'm hearing, وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ مُوسَى And what Musa brought, يخرج من مشكاة واحدة comes out from the same source. وكذلك, نريد حادثة أخرى الآن, سنتقرب الوضع شوي. حادثة مشابهة. كلام مثل هذا مشابه أيضا ذكره واحد من أتباع أهل الكتاب. لا أخي بارك الله فيك. ورقة بن نوفل. ورقة بن نوفل. When you open صحيح البخاري the كتاب of الوحي you will find the story. شيخ الإسلام يقول وكذلك ورقة بن نوفل وهو من أحبار نصارى العرب لما سمع كلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال له إنه يأتيك الناموس الذي يأتي موسى يا ليتني فيه جذعة حين يخرجك قومك فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو مخرجيهم قال نعم لم يأتي أحد بمثل ما أتيت به إلا عوديا وإن يدركني يومك أنصرك نصرا مؤزرا. As reported in صحيح البخاري one of the people of the book His name is Waraqa bin Nawfal. And he was a relative of Khadija, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Khadija took what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, took the news to whom? To check it out with Waraqa bin Nawfal and to tell him about what happened to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّهُ يَأْتِيكَ النَّامُوسِ And النَّامُوسِ, this is a reference to whom? To Jibreel alayhi السلام. يعني الناموس احسن ما وجدنا في معناها انه صاحب السر الخير. The one who carries the good and hidden news. وهو جبريل عليه السلام. انه يأتيك الناموس وهنا وجه الشاهد الذي يأتي من موسى. The one that came to موسى عليه السلام. يا ليتني فيه جذعة. الجذع هو الصغير من البهائم. و كان كأنه يعني أن يكون شابا عند ظهور الإسلام الرجل هذا يعني. He said I wish I am like a young sheep meaning that he loves to be or he wishes to be a young person when the message of Islam is spreading or spreads out. حين يخرجك قومك when your people will drive you out. He informed him that your people will drive you out. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked, do they or will they? He said yes. Nobody came with what you brought except that his people opposed him and on that he said, وَإِنْ يُدْرِكْنِ يَوْمُكْ أَنْ سُوكَ نَصْرَ مُؤَذَّرَ If I have to live to that day, I will give you my full support. أيضا ولهذا يقرن سبحانه وتعالى بين التوراة والقرآن. And that's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى always make قرن make association when he mentions the Quran and makes a reference to التوراة as Allah سبحانه وتعالى says فلما جاءهم الحق من عندنا قالوا لولا أوتي مثل ما أوتي موسى أولم يكفروا بما أوتي موسى من قبل قالوا سحران تظاهرا يعني التوراة والقرآن وفي قراءة أخرى يقول شيخ الإسلام قالوا إيه ساحران يقصدون مين محمد وموسى عليه السلام but when this is in سورة القصص سورة 28 28 القصص right? I think so 28 ayah 48 49.
But when the truth that is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his message has come to them from us, from Allah, they say, why is it, why is not given the light of what was given to Moses? Didn't they disbelieve in that which was given to Moses before? They said two kinds of magic.
They refer to Torah, the Torah and the Quran.
Each helping
the other.
And they say, verily, in both we are disbelievers. Say, O Muhammad, to them, then bring a book from Allah which is a better guide than the two that I may follow if you are truthful.
And of course, they couldn't.
يقول فلم ينزل كتاب من عند الله أهدى من التوراة والقرآن.
There is no book that was revealed or brought down from Allah سبحانه وتعالى
better in guidance than the Torah and the Quran.
Of course, when Allah سبحانه وتعالى speaks about the Torah, it speaks about the original Torah.
That's it.
Not the altered ones that exist nowadays.
ثم قال تعالى فإن لم يستجيبوا لك فاعلم انما يتبعون اهواءهم ومن اضل ممن اتبع هواه بغير هدى من الله ان الله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين.
But if they answer you not, that is they don't believe in the oneness of Allah,
then know that they only follow their own lust. And who is more astray than the one who follows his own lust without guidance from Allah?
Verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides not the people who are zalimeen.
Zalimeen, wrongdoers, polytheists, disbelievers, etc.
Criminals, etc.
يقول الآن what is the first claim that came in the letter?
أول دعوة in the letter of the bishop.
أول دعوة في كتاب الأسرة. يقول يذكر رحمه الله ما جاء في كتاب الأسقف من أنه قام بسؤال أكابر النصارى.
That this bishop asked the prominent members of the Christian community at his time, people of knowledge in their deen, in their religion. And he asked them the following. Listen to the questions that were raised by the bishop to the learned people of the Christians. Listen what he said to them.
هذا الذي قاله الآن الأسقف يسأل علماءه.
الأسقف يسأل علماء.
يقول إن سمعنا أنه قد ظهر إنسان من العرب اسمه محمد يقول إنه رسول الله وأتى بكتاب فذكر أنه نزل من الله.
We heard, so he's speaking to the Christian scholar. He's saying that we heard that a man from Arabia came by the name of Muhammad and that he brought a book with him. And he mentioned that this book was brought down to him from Allah. فلم نزل إلى أن حصل الكتاب عندنا.
We kept
searching حتى حصلنا على القرآن. حصلنا على الكتاب.
قال يقول من الأسقف. يعني حصلنا القرآن يقول الآن وعارضوا الآن على أكابر القوم. ذهب إلى روم. ذهب إلى صقلية. ذهب إلى تركيا. ذهب إلى أنطاكيا. ما خلى واحد من كبار القوم إلا عرض عليه هذه الأسئلة. هذا الرجال عجيب.
He said, I told this scholar,
إذا كنتم قد سمعتم بهذا الكتاب وهذا الإنسان واستهدتم على تحصيل هذا الكتاب الذي أتي به عندكم فلأي حال لم تتبعوه؟
He said, if you have heard about this book and about this man and you put the effort to bring this book which is now in your hand
فلأي حال لم تتبعوه؟
Then why you don't follow it?
ولا سيما شوف ناو هي كوت فروم ذا قران يقول ولا سيما في الكتاب يقول ومن يبتغي غير الاسلام دينا فلن يقبل منه وهو في الاخره من الخاسرين.
Especially it is cited in this book the saying ومن يبتغي غير الاسلام دينا.
Anyone who seeks a religion, a deen other than that of Islam, it will not be accepted from him,
the translation of the meaning,
and on the day of judgment or in the hereafter, he will be among the losers.
Of course, this is in Surah Al-Imran, Surah Al-Imran, Surah 3, Ayah 85.
أجابوا قائلين. انتبه الآن إجابة من؟
النصارى أهل العلم عندهم قالوا لأحوال شتى because of يعني many reasons or due to certain to many فقال فقلت ما هي what are they what preventing you from believing نعم هو الأسطر هو ذهب يناقش هؤلاء يعني علماءهم فيقول اعطوني لماذا لا وهذا فيه هذا واجتهدتم ويقول اجتهدتم بأنكم أحضرتم الكتاب عندكم فأخبروني لماذا لا تتبعوا وفيه هذا النص فقالوا لأحوال شتى فقلت ما هي لما said to them يعني explain what are they قالوا منها أن الكتاب عربي that this book is in the Arabic language وليس بلساننا and it's not in our tongue حسب ما جاء فيه الآن يأخذون إيش النصوص اللي هم استندوا فيها على هذه المقولة حسب ما جاء فيه إنا أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا said well this book is in Arabic and it's not in our mother tongue and we read in it they say إنا أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا in سورة يوسف Surah 12, Ayah 2. Verily, we have sent it down as an Arabic Quran in order that you may understand. This is the ayah which they cited. هذه الآية اللي هم استدلوا فيها. ثم قال. وقال يعني في موضع آخر يقولون وقال بلسان عربي مبين بلسان عربي مبين. هذه شواهدهم أو أدلتهم. وهذه في سورة الشعراء. من سورة الشعراء وفي سورة 26. آية 198 آية 195 In a plain Arabic tongue The translation of the reading This is the text that they cited And also they cited وَلَوْ نَزَّلْنَاهُ عَلَى بَعْضِ الْأَعْجَمِينَ فَقَرَأَهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ إِهْ مؤمنين also we read in there they say and if we had revealed it that is the Quran unto any of the non-Arab And he had recited it unto them, they would not have believed in it. This is also in the same surah, Surah Al-Shu'ara, Surah 26, but Ayah 198 and 199. ويقولون وقال في سورة البقرة and also it is cited in سورة البقرة, Surah 2, Ayah 151, كما أرسلنا فيكم رسولا منكم يتلو عليكم آياتنا ويزكيكم ويعلمكم الكتاب والحكمة ويعلمكم ما لم تكونوا تعلمون Similarly, to complete my blessings on you, we have sent among you a messenger, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, of your own, reciting to you our ayat. And sanctifying you and telling you the book, the Quran and hikmah. Hikmah, يا إخوان, هي السنة وأيضا هي الإسلامك ويز. All Islamic ways are hikmah. So this is what they cited. In continuity also they go, لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته. آل عمران also they cited the verse in آل عمران آية 164 which is سورة 3 آية 164. Indeed Allah conferred a great favor on the believers when he sent among them a messenger from among themselves reciting unto them his ayat, his verses. وقال تعالى في سورة القصص also they're still fighting verses from the Quran. In سورة القصص which is 28 آية 46 لتنذر قوما ما أتاهم من نذير من مثلك لعلهم يتذكرون But you are sent as a mercy from your Rabb, your Rabb, Allah, to give warning to a people to whom no warner has come before you, in order that they remember and or receive admonition. وقال في سورة السجدة لتنذر قوما ما أتاهم من نذير من قبلك لعلهم يهتدون. ما زالوا النصارى يعني يستشهدون بهذه الآيات بالإجابة. إن سورة السجدة لتنظر قوما and to give warning to a people or a nation ما انظر من قبلك لعلهم يهتدون. They were not given warning before you or Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, so they may receive guidance. And also they cited in Surah Yasin لتنذر قوما ما انذر اباؤهم فهم غافلون. Also to give warning to people whose forefathers were not warned, etc. نعم بدر. Still continuing. This is just the beginning. قالوا. They said. فلما رأينا هذا يقولونهم. لما رأينا هذه الآيات علمنا أنه لم يأتي إلينا. When we read those verses in the Quran, we knew then that he is not sent to us. بل إلى جاهلية العرب. To whom he was sent? Only to the people of ignorance of the Arabs. الذين قال فيهم. Then they replied, or they give an evidence, their evidence. أنه لم يأتهم رسول ولا نذير من مثله. That they have not received before a messenger or a warner like him. وَإِنَّهُ لَا يَلْزَمُنَا اتِّبَاعُهُ. And therefore it is not incumbent on us to follow him. It's not obligatory on us to follow him. لأننا يقولون قد أتانا رسل من قبله. Because we have received messengers before him. خاطبونا يا باش مهندس يا اشت لو تقرب على الأخوان هناك عشان تكون معهم وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معه بفضله وإحسانه وكرمه. Today we will this is going to be a instead of a lecture it's going to be some sort of a training session and it will concentrate basically on taking you around the Bible to know the book of the Ahl al-Kitab because sometimes it is easier to prove a point by taking the witness of the opponent and taking his word as to support your point. Not because we as Muslims want to rely on the Bible instead of the Quran and Sunnah. A'udhu billahi min dhalik. We only do that because we want to take from the Bible, right? What proves our point. Now, our position of the Bible. We believe the Bible contains truth. But not all what is in the Bible is true. Follow me. We believe the Bible to contain truth. But not everything that is in the Bible is true. Right? Because the scribe changed it. Right? Now, the Bible, the word Bible comes from the Greek word biblos, which means collection of books. Collection of books. So it is, the Bible means books. Not one book, but books. Arabs, يا شيخ نهار شارك الأخوان جلسوا بطريقة بحيث تكونوا مع بعض يا أخوان جلس مع أخوان أو أنكم روحوا هنا كلكم المسجل بس you'll find many people referring to the Bible as the Injil, right? I normally don't, nor do the Christians refer to it as the Injil. They refer to it as the Holy Book, they refer to it as Al-Kitab Al-Muqaddas, they refer to it as العهد القديم والعهد الجديد, the Old Testament and the New Testament. They don't refer to it as the Torah or the Injil. Right?
So I don't normally, I personally do not refer to the Bible as the Injil, nor do I refer to it as the Torah. Psalm or Zabur is also included. We will go over this in the Holy Book. Okay, in the Bible. But it is not called a Zabur. Psalm is a Zabur. So the Bible contains the Old Testament, the New Testament, and other parts. We will talk about that. Right. How many versions are there of the Bible? There are three major categories, three major versions. The Orthodox Bible contains 80 books. Remember, this is a collection of books. So when I say book, we will see what book means, like a chapter in a textbook. Right? So the Orthodox book or Bible contains 80 books. The Catholic Bible contains 73 books. Seven are removed as not accepted. The Protestant book or Bible contains 66 books. Again, another seven are removed. 66 books. The Bible that you have between your hands are the 66 book version. Okay? I do not have with me the 73 book version, nor do I have with me the 80 book version. Okay? Okay. The 80 book version is not common because the Orthodox tends to be in Russia and in, let's talk about where the Orthodox are. Russia, Cyprus, if there are Christians, Turkish in Turkey, they will be Orthodox. Both the Serbia is Orthodox. Okay? The Coptic are Orthodox. Bulgaria, what they call the Eastern Bloc are mostly Orthodox. There are Catholics as well. Now Europe, you will find it to be, and America, you will find it to be mostly Catholic and or Protestant. In the Philippines, mostly Catholic and Protestant. In fact, the Philippines is the largest Catholic population. In the Philippines, you will find the largest Catholic population, and that's why the Catholic Church now is very upset because it is losing its members to other denominations, such as the Galatian Christo and the other Protestant sects. Okay? For example, the born again and so forth. There are two other denominations that I did not list, and the reason is as follows. I will tell you the reason. There is the Mormon, and there is the Jehovah's Witnesses. There are so many other names, but why I name these two? Because the Mormons, they have their own books in addition to King James Version, the one that is with a golden frame. The golden frame, this is the King James Version. The Mormons use that version plus their books, three books, or a book of three sections, either way. They, Jehovah's Witnesses, consider the Bible to be full of holes, and they use their own book, but they are still consider themselves to be Christian. Fair enough? So these two denominations, the Jehovah's Witnesses and the Mormons, are two special groups. They have their own books in addition to the Bible. Okay? Now, the Catholic. The Catholic Bible is divided to three. You remember I said Al-Ahd Al-Qadim and Al-Ahd Al-Jadid? No. In the Catholic Bible there are three sections. 39 books. First 39 books are called the Old Testament. Al-Ahd Al-Qadim. Seven books are called the Apocrypha. The Apocrypha. The 27 books, the last of 27 books are called the New Testament or Al-Ahd Al-Jadid. Quiet? Understood? Do you follow? When I lose you, throw something at me, so I know. Stop me. Do not wait until I lose you. Before I lose you, catch me. 39 books of the Catholic and the Protestant. The first 39 books are called the Old Testament. Next, if you have a Catholic book, you will find the seven books called the Apocrypha. Apocrypha in the dictionary means hidden. Now it is known to be the faulty or the modified. But actually the word Apocrypha means the hidden. Orthodox means the Catholic, all the Catholics refer to the church, the Pope in Rome. Okay? The Orthodox are called like the old form, the original form, as for a lack of a better word. When you say an Orthodox, sometimes they say this man is an Orthodox Muslim, meaning a Muslim that did not modify, like original. Right? Conservative if you want. Right? But Catholicism is the where it starts in Rome or in from the Pope is the head of the Catholic Church. The Pope in Rome is the head of the Vatican is the head of the Catholic Church. The Protestants are those who did not like Catholicism, they split off. Of Catholicism. It started with the, I think, with the King James of England or of Britain, when he wanted to marry another woman, they did not agree, so he broke off and he made his Church of England. There are they broke from the time of the Revolution, if you will, the Revolution. Now, the first 39 books, as I said, are the Old Testament. Next to that, if it is a Catholic book, it would contain what? The Apocrypha. Yes, that's it. Yes. Catholicism. But that is none of the. It is these are not the Orthodox nor the Catholic nor the Protestant. These are the Unitarians, and that is way at that time, 325-381. From that point, it became the mind.
From
Yeah, but what I am saying, correct me if I am wrong, I think even the Orthodox are Polonian somehow. They are not. So the split really didn't take that place at that time. I do not have the exact history as when the breakup between Orthodox Catholicism and so forth. But what is important to me now is to know that there are these three major parts. But thank you very much, Doctor. Jazakallah khair. Now. The last 27 books are called the New Testament, right? Now, the first 39 books open to the table of contents. The first 39 books, starting with Genesis, table of contents, please. Either of the two Bibles. The table of contents. You open to table of contents. يا جماعة اللي ما عنده شاركوا جروب التحقوا كل واحد منكم التحق بجروب. روح مع جروب هذيك وواحد منكم يروح مع الجروب اللي بعديها. يا أخ أيوة روح مع الجماعة أنا. Did you find the table of contents? Do not mark the Bible, please. 39, the contents you find in the table of contents that it is split. The Old Testament at the top, the New Testament at the bottom. See that? Table of contents, you are not at the table of contents, are you? Yeah, okay, you are. You were. No, go back. That is the alphabetical arrangement. Okay? Now, the first five books. The first five books. Starting with Genesis. Exodus, Numbers, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. The order is Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and then Deuteronomy. These five books are called the books of Moses. The law. No, not the Ahd al-Qadim. Ahd al-Qadim all the way down to the 39 books. Follow me. 39 books are called, 39 books, you see them in front of you, are called the Old Testament. But the first five books, are called the books of Moses. Follow that? Or the law. Find that? From thereafter, all the 34 books following that until the end of the New Testament, or the Old Testament, excuse me, is the prophetic. One of them, you will find, is Psalm. It is written with a P. P-S-A-L-M.
Number 19.
Is it 19? Psalm. This is Az-Zabur. This is supposed to be a Zabur, because this is the book of David. You follow that? Got that? Found that, brother? Number 19 is a book that starts with a P, silent P, Psalm. The Psalm is the book of David, or a Zabur. Supposed to be a Zabur. Right? Clear? To me or to you? Fine? No? What is it? Number 19. First five books, we said they are the books of Moses. Then number 19 is called Psalm, starting with a P. It starts with a P. Yeah, table of contents. Table of contents, number 19 is called Psalm. It's not number probably, huh? Just count down. Found it? So that is Psalm, and Psalm is the book of David, and therefore it is the Zabur, or it's supposed to be the Zabur. Right?
Right.
Now we go to the New Testament. The New Testament is divided as follows. The first four books, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, are called the canonical books. Canonized books. Canonized means approved. Canonized means approved. Right? The fifth book is called the book of Acts, or the Acts of the Prophets. A'mal al-Rusul. Al-Rusul. It is not canonized, but the author is the same author as the third book, Luke. Luca. Luca wrote Acts. Luca, Luke, wrote Acts. But Acts is not canonized. It's not approved. No, not the same degree of approval, if you would. Okay?
Okay.
Now, from Acts, after Acts comes Romans. From Romans to Hebrews are 14 books. These are the books of Paul. The letters, they are called the letters of Paul. They are books, but they are referred to as the letters of Paul. Following? Still with me? Tracking? Or off track? I said, after Acts comes Romans. From Romans to Hebrews are called the books, or the letters of Paul. The letters of Paul. Romans to Hebrews. Some evangelists cast some doubt on Hebrews. Some evangelists cast some doubt on Hebrews. Okay? Let's stick to the divisions now. Then after that, there are seven books written by the disciples, supposed to be written by the disciples of Jesus. Peter, John, James, okay, two for Peter, two for John, I think, and one for James. No, and what else? Three for John, two for Peter, right? Three for John, two for Peter, three for John, what else? One for James, that is what, six so far, huh? And one for, it's called the judge, or Jude. Right. The last book is called the Revelation. And this, it is written by someone called John. But it is not John who wrote that John, nor is it John that wrote the number four book. It's a third John. Yet a third John. Right?
Right.
The John that wrote John, the Gospel of John, which is the fourth book, is also not known who that John is. He is not one of the disciples. He is not known who John is. Although it is a canonized book, but John is not known. Okay? Now, Mark was 10 years old when Jesus was on earth. And he is the nephew of the disciple Barnabas. He is the nephew of the disciple Barnabas. But Barnabas, you don't find no book here in for him in these books, in the Bible. Right? Mark is the author of Mark. The Gospel of Mark, the Gospel according to Mark. Now Matthew and Luke seem to have copied from Mark. And you will find similarities between Mark and Luke on one hand, and Mark and Matthew on the other hand. Are you following me so far? Okay. Now I say from the very beginning that the Orthodox have 80 books. Right? The Catholics have 73 books in their Bible, and the Protestants have 66 books. But you will find listed in the Bible, I unfortunately did not bring the reference with me, but you will find if you search 15 other books referred to in the Bible, but they are not found anywhere. They do not exist, but they are referred to 15 different books, additional books. So that makes it 95. Right? The Gospel of Barnabas, which is not accepted by the church, makes the 96th book. Yes.
Where are they referred to?
I do not know. In every, all the Bibles, but it refers to them, but they do not exist. Okay? And you find that very clarified very well by the Mormons. The Mormons are the people who, you know, dug this up. Okay, you follow now? So, from 96 books, you go down to 66 books, as if you are an Orthodox, if you are a Protestant, and you go down to 73 books if you are Catholic, 80 books if you are Orthodox. Right? Okay. So, of the Protestant book, Bible, there are many versions. The oldest that is common, that is available in libraries, is the King James Version, the one with the golden frame on the cover. King James Version is written in Old English. Right? And Yusuf Ali, when he translated interpreted the Quran and translated that into English, wrote his translation in that style of a language. Because people respect the higher level language, the old language. But it makes it harder on the people to understand. Yusuf Ali is the translator of the Tarjamat al-Ma'ani al-Quran. Okay, we'll bring that up. Okay? The King James Version is written in what? In Old English. No, it's an Old English. It says, thou shalt not do this. Instead, you should not. It says, thou shalt not. Thou meaning you. Okay? Classical Old English. It's not used anymore. Except in the church now. If you use the King James Version. The new International Version uses the today's language, today's English. Right? But there are more. It's not only a change from one language, from one style of a language to the other, the difference between these two Bibles. But we will discuss that later when we have time. There are differences between each and every version. You see, version is not an addition, but it is a version. Sigha. not nuskha, صيغة. ها؟ مش اصدار، صيغة. لانه يصاغ 100% يتغير. صيغة. Version, when you, if you know software. Software, you have version 1, 0, version 1, version 2, you change it. You don't call it version 1. When you have version 1, when you have version 2, it is changed very much. But if it is only changed slightly, then it is version 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3. But when you change to version 2, it is changed very much. There are many changes between one version and the other. Okay? Okay. The Old Testament language, I was asked, what language? The Old Testament was written in Hebrew. Old Hebrew, ancient Hebrew. Not current day Hebrew, but in Old Hebrew. The New Testament was written in Greek. Old Greek. Then at one time, it was written into, the whole Bible was written into Latin to free the changes, because Latin is, does not change as fast as English, for example, changes. No, there is nothing called original. Latin is an old one, but it is not the original. There is old English and there is, so, yeah, it's all of them originate from there, but it is not the original. You know, it's not the original. Jesus, peace be upon him, spoke Aramaic, which is one version of Hebrew. But it was not the necessarily what was the Old Testament was written in, but it wasn't Greek either. I do not know the exact differences between Hebrew and Aramaic. Maybe Dr. Saleh has any idea. So it is a form of Hebrew. Yeah, it's a form of Hebrew, but what is the difference between Aramaic and the other Hebrews? I don't know. Yeah, it's a form of Hebrew. Aramaic is a form of Hebrew. But it is not, what Dr. Saleh is saying, that Sheikh Islam ibn Taymiyyah says anyone who believes that Jesus spoke other language than Hebrew is mistaken. Fine. Aramaic is a form of Hebrew, but I don't know the difference between this level and the other level and so forth. It is not, it's not apparent to me as the difference, for example, between Shakespeare English, that is the Old Testament style, and today English. I do not know the difference. I do not know Hebrew. I do not know Hebrew. Maybe Dr. Saleh should, by neighboring them, should have learned Hebrew, but probably he didn't. Shalom, that's all. I know one verse which is Shema Israelu Adonai Elohainu Adonai Echad. That is Hebrew, but I will explain that later. That's the only Hebrew I know. Shema Israelu Adonai Elohainu Adonai Echad. Since we are at it, let's explain it, because we will waste time. Shema Israelu Adonai Elohainu Adonai Echad is what Musa alayhi salam said when he was asked who was Allah was, who God was. He said, Ya Bani Israel, innama ilahukum ilahun wahid. Shema Israelu, O children of Israel, your Lord, your God, your Lord is one. Okay? And when they asked Musa, Isa alayhi salam, who is God? He said, Shema Israelu Allah, Shema Israelu Adonai Elohainu Adonai Echad. Same answer. When they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they asked him, he went silent for a while and he said, Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, Allahu Samad. Qul huwa Allahu Ahad. Say he is Allah, God is Echad, Ahad. Same, one. شما إسرائيل أدناهي إلهين أدناهي إكا. Okay. If you need, we can give you. I can give you later the references where you find these things. So, if I say, for example, find me the letter of Paul. If I say, find me the letter of Paul to the Romans, where do you look? So then in the New Testament, correct? The sixth book in the New Testament, right? Now, for example, brother, what's your name? Ahmed. Why don't you please read for us Romans chapter 1, verses 20 to 23. Yes. This book is available on the Protestant book Bible. It is available in the Catholic Bible, and it is available on the Orthodox Bible. Chapter 1, verse 20 to 23. Please start. Wait a minute. Not everybody has found it. Yeah, it doesn't matter. But yeah, read from that because it is easier English. But let everyone find it. The New Testament, remember, the New Testament is the last part of the book. Right? Now, it is not only, this is not a lecture, this is a lesson, training. You have to find yourself and struggle finding. Did you find it? Chapter Romans. If you don't know, go to the table of contents and there is the page number. Now, each book starts with several chapters. Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. And then each chapter is divided into verses. Verse 1, verse 2, verse 3. And like the Quran, the verse number comes before the verse, not after the verse. The verse number comes before the verse, not after the verse. So chapter 20, verse 1, chapter 1, verse 20, when you find chapter 1, you will find 20 and then the start of the verse. I do not have this with me. You have it. You found it? By the way, New International Version, thank you, Ahmed, is called also, is referred to as the NIV. Meaning New International Version. The Catholic Bible is referred to as the Douay Version. Douay Version. Figure? No? Yes? Found it, everyone? Raise your hand if you didn't find it. $793 in the New International Version. Okay, you found it? Everyone? Ahmed, stop, Listen to the meaning, please. And by the way, the Old Testament, you will find it to be, King James Version, you will find it to be slightly different. But listen to the meaning, because you will be surprised when you hear what is written there. Read.
Although the human body is not yet glorified in itself, nor is it transgressed, but the thing is the same as the type and the quality of the body. That's what he said. Although the human body is not
Continue to the 51, 24th, 25th. You see? This book, it is different, but the meaning, I'm showing you the two versions because so you know that there are differences, but at the same time, I want you to get the meaning. Did you notice what is being written here? The Catholic this book is available in the Catholic Bible. Did you not say that? But look, it is talking very harshly about making images. But those who have any idea about the Catholic Church, don't you know that the Church is surrounded from outside and from inside with statues? Correct? So these people, the Christians, are not shown the truth. The followers of the Church, they don't know the Bible. They do not read the Bible to learn. They do not, it does not strike them, you know, surprising. What is this? They are not supposed to have statues. Correct? But it is written here that they are not supposed to take statues. Somebody is whispering graven images. Who is that? Ahmed. You find that in Exodus chapter 20 verse 5. Chapter 20 verses 1 to 5. Exodus is the second book of Moses. So it is the second book in the Bible. Second book in the Bible. Open to the second book in the Bible, chapter 20 verse 1 to 5. Chapter 20, verses 1 to 5. Found it, everyone? You are not at the first book, the second book, brother. Second book is from the right, from the left side. From the beginning of the Bible, the second book is called Exodus. It's the second book of Moses. Found it, everyone? Chapter 20, verses 1 to 5. You found it? Ahmed, read. By the way, the Balak Islam, your job is to show your neighbor how to go around the Bible. That's why you are my assistant today. But those who do not have an assistant, come to the front or something like that. If you want, come to the front, close to Abdul Aziz or... Mashi Hal Kukhtay. Okay, Ahmed. Okay. Now the graven images are found in the King James Version. If you read King James Version, it says, see thy God, I am the Lord
thy God instead of your God. Thee instead of you. Any graven images? Image? Okay. Okay. So thou shalt instead of should not shall not. Thou shalt take unto thyself. Okay. Graven images. That's old English. All right. So whether you go to the Old Testament or the New Testament, it condemns taking images, idols. But unfortunately, the church does not speak of that. Everybody goes to Mother Mary, if you are a woman, and says, Mother Mary, please, I need to be pregnant. Right? They pray to Mother Mary. Okay? And the saints, every day there is a saint. There is for every saint there is a day in the year. 365 or 366 different saints. And for each and every wish type there is a saint. Just like the Romans when they had a god for the war, and a god for the sea, and a god for I don't know what, for the spring, and so forth. Right? So this is copying idolatry. Nonetheless, they talk about Muslims as pagans. They talk about Muslims as pagans, because Muslims, they think, are worshipping the Kaaba. And they are worshipping the black stone. That's what they think. Instead of referring to their Bible and seeing what is it they are doing in contradiction to the very book that they carry and say this is a divine book. Is it a divine book? How do you know?
Huh? Must be avoided because it stands for Anno Domino. Is that right? Latin. And it means in the year of the Lord. And referring to Jesus alayhi salam as the Lord. Jesus, peace be upon him, was an honorable prophet. He is not Allah, and Muslims should always use the Hijra-based calendar. And if they want to use the corresponding date, they shouldn't write the AD, instead write CE, which abbreviation for the Christian era. Okay? So 1995 CE, capital. So he was born in 1263 CE in Harran, and he grew up in Damascus, Syria. He mastered various disciplines of Islamic studies at an early age. And he strongly defended the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and stood firmly against innovation. ووقف بكثير من البدع ودافع عن سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now you will know why I'm speaking about Ibn Taymiyyah, and one moment, just be patient, please. He strongly defended the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and stood firmly against innovations introduced by philosophers and Ahlul Kalam, scholastics. The scholastic sect, Ahlul Kalam, who on numerous occasions plotted for his imprisonment in Damascus and in Cairo. والذين وشوا فيه وأدت هذه الوشاية إلى سجنه في دمشق وفي القاهرة. Even in prison, he continued to call for a Salaf Saleh's way of understanding of Islam. So much that his opponents were driven to deprive him from writing material. يعني أخذوا منه حتى القرطاسية والدواه للحبر والكتابة. فكان يكتب بالفحم. وكان المساجين في القاهرة كل ما تأتي نوبة لإطلاق صراحهم يقولوا لا نريد أن نخرج، لأنه كان يعلمهم القرآن والتفسير والحديث. كل ما كان يأتي عفو عنهم يقولوا نريد أن نبقى. So much that his opponents were driven to deprive him from writing material. He said, commenting on his imprisonment, ماذا يفعل أعدائي بي؟ How could my foes do to me? Or what could my foes do to me? Salaam. My paradise is in my heart. These are his words. My paradise is in my heart. And my garden is in my chest. It does not leave me wherever I go. What is he reflecting? He's reflecting his enjoyment in the belief in Allah. Because he is on a light from Allah that enlightens his heart and his chest. This is the true Jannah in this life. He's like the twin gardens, moving freely and enjoying every bit of his life, even if he was in jail. Opposite to this, imagine the life of the hypocrite. Though they are free outside, but their chests are confined and restricted. He continues to say, my imprisonment is khalwa. In the sajni, khalwa. Khalwa means retreat. In a retreat where he devoted himself to Allah, writing about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to worship him and how to know Allah by his name and his attributes. In his jail in Cairo, he wrote 5 volumes called Al-Fatawa Al-Kubra, or known as Al-Fatawa Al-Masriya, without having the Quran or any hadith as reference, all from his chest. إن قتلي شهادة. Killing me is شهادة, which is dying for the cause of Allah. وإخراجي من بلدي سياحة. ليس سياحة لمفهوم الآن. Deporting me from my country is سياحة, and is traveling to explore Allah's creation, carrying with him the cause of Islam and enjoying da'wah for the sake of Allah, even in jail. He strongly defended the names and attributes of Allah and all aspects of Aqeedah. ليش هذا يهمنا قضية الأسماء والصفات لله؟ تذكرون ماذا قلنا منذ لحظات؟ أنك تدعو إلى أن يعبد الله وحده. طيب ألا تريد أن تعرف الله للناس؟ كيف تريد أن توضح للناس أن الله وحده يستحق العبادة إذا لم تكن تعرف مدلولات ومعاني أسماؤه وصفاته؟ هذا محال, ما تستطيع. لازم تعرف هذا حتى تكون على بينة بمن تريد أن تثبت للقوم الآخرين أنه يستحق العبادة. يستحق العبادة لأن كل أسماؤه وصفاته كمال سبحانه. And this we will talk about it thoroughly, inshallah. He strongly defended the names and attributes of Allah and all aspects of Aqeedah, belief. When he confirmed the attributes of Allah as confirmed in the Quran and Sunnah and without any alterations in their meanings, the innovators from the people of Kalam plotted against him and he was sentenced to jail. That's why he entered the jail. Because he confirmed what Allah confirmed for himself in his book, the Quran, and what the Prophet ﷺ confirmed about Allah's names and attributes in his sunnah, without any alteration, without any modification. فأثبت لله سبحانه وتعالى ما أثبت الله لنفسه في كتابه وما أثبته النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم له من أسماء وصفات تليق بجلاله. طيب اسمع الفراية الآن بتاعت ابن بطوطة. Have you heard of ابن بطوطة? The famous traveler? People enjoy reading his books. Not many, but some. We know from a hadith, نحن نعلم من حديث صحيح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, we know from a hadith which is authentic, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends in the latter part of the third part of the night to the إلى السماء الدنيا, to the first heaven. he descends. ينزل الله سبحانه وتعالى إلى السماء الدنيا، لكن نزول يليق بجلاله. كيفية النزول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لم يخبرنا كيفية النزول، لكن كيفيته يجب أن تليق به بجلاله سبحانه وتعالى وعظمته. كيفيته نحن غير مطالبين بالسؤال عن الكيفية، لكن نعلم أن الحديث صح وحق. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us that Allah descends to the first heaven, to the lower heaven, سماء الدنيا في الثلث الأخير من الليل. Ibn Battuta said, look, Ibn Taymiyyah spent his life defending the names and attributes of Allah, and there comes somebody who says this. He says, Ibn Battuta in the year 704 to 780 after Hijrah, which corresponds to 1304 to 1378 in the Christian era, he said, Ibn Battuta, I was in Damascus when on a Friday I attended the Friday sermon in which Ibn Taymiyyah was admonishing people while standing on the pulpit of the mosque, and that he said among other things that God comes down from heaven to earth just as I am now coming down the steps of the minbar or the pulpit. He steps one step down the minbar. والعياذ بالله. يقول هذا ابن تيمية في كذبة، يقول هذا ابن بطوطة في كذبة على هذه الحادثة التي سيبين كذبها. يقول انه انا رأيت في يوم جمعة ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله. لماذا انا اخبركم بهذا؟ I tell you the story because it is written in many books that are in Arabic, in Urdu, and be aware of it. I have seen it. The same story. Not only that, but this person, the Orientalist, Cyril Glessé, in his Encyclopedia of Islam, has mentioned the same story, trying to deform the Aqidah of Ibn Taymiyyah. The same story, without any verification. So this man says, I was in Damascus on a Friday, and I saw Ibn Taymiyyah on the giving a sermon, خطبة الجمعة. ويقول الحديث الذي ذكرناه، وأنه ينزل سبحانه وتعالى كنزول هذا، ونزل ثلاث درجات عن المنبر. طيب، سيريل جلسي in his book The Concise Encyclopedia of Islam 1989 edition page 176 mentions Ibn Battuta's story saying that he Ibn Taymiyyah is quote famous for having said in a Friday sermon that God comes down etc. But look now at the facts. Here are the facts. Number one, we all know that Ibn Taymiyyah spent most of his life believing in the perfect attributes of Allah and that nothing is like unto Allah. Second, Ibn Battuta did not hear anything directly from Ibn Taymiyyah, nor did he meet him. That is because Ibn Battuta arrived in Damascus into the tawarikh. He arrived in Damascus on the 19th of the month of Ramadan, which is the 9th month of the Islamic calendar, right? يعني الشهر التاسع. وصل إلى دمشق في الشهر إيه؟ شهر رمضان اللي هو شهر 9. طيب. On the year 700 or in the year 726, recall this, 726 after Hijra. Ibn Taymiyyah entered the jail in Damascus in early Sha'ban. In early Sha'ban, which is what? The 8th month. هذا دخل قبل رمضان. Ibn Taymiyyah دخل السجن قبل رمضان في 8 Sha'ban. طيب. هل خرج من السجن ذاك الوقت؟ لا. And remained in it until he died on the 20th of Dhul Qa'dah, which is the 11th month of the year 728 after Hijra. So, how did Ibn Battuta see and hear from Ibn Taymiyyah? Ibn Battuta's travels are filled with strange narrations and stories that are not true. For example, he mentioned the glorification of certain graves without denouncing that it is not an Islamic practice. يعني Ibn Taymiyyah, هذا Ibn Battuta, في رحلاته لو ما تقرأها وجد كثير من الأماكن فيها قبور ويشوف يعني يرى أو رأى ناس حول هذه القبور وعظموا هذه القبور ولم إيش ينكر ذلك، بل أنه حين كان في أحد البحار في إحدى البحار ذكر يعني استنجد بأحد ما يسمون بالأولياء. ونحن نعرف أن مشركي العرب حين كانوا في البحار ويمرون بالصعاب كانوا يستنجدوا بمن؟
بالله عز وجل، لكن لما ينزلوا على الشط يشركوا. هذا هو في قلب البحر ما استنجد الا بولي. So be aware. ابن تيمية on the other hand يا اخوان، ابن تيمية ما اعطى خطب جمعة. ابن تيمية كان يعطي دروس من صدره وهو جالس على كرسي في المسجد الاموي في دمشق، يعطي دروس فقط، ما كان يعطي خطب جمعة. Ibn Taymiyyah did not give Friday sermons, he used to give durus, which are Islamic discussions, while sitting on a chair in the Umayyad Mosque. So, when they led him to his cell, حينما أخذوه إلى زنزانته, in Al Qal'a prison, في سجن القلعة في دمشق, and they closed the door, سكروا الباب, he smiled, تبسم, وقرأ قوله عز وجل, فضرب بينهم بسور له باب, باطنه فيه الرحمة, وظاهره من قبله العذاب. So a wall will be put up between them with a gate therein. Inside it will be mercy and outside it will be torment. سورة الحديد آية 13. He once said, the truly jailed one is the person who withheld his heart from his Rabb. And he, the confined one is the person who confined himself to his desire. والمأسور من أثره هواه. Ibn Taymiyyah physically defended the Muslims in Asham, in Greater Syria, against invasions by the Tatar. He died in the year 728 after Hijrah, which corresponds to 1328. While in jail in Damascus, his great student Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyya, who was with him in the same cell, Ibn al-Qayyim كان معه في نفس الزنزانة, said, he was reciting the Quran, كان يقرأ القرآن, and when he finished reciting the ayah, ولما انتهى من قراءة الآية التالية, إن المتقين في جنات ونهر في مقعد صدق عند مليك مقتدر فاضت روحه. There is the muttaqeen, pious and righteous persons who fear Allah much and love Him much will be in the midst of gardens and rivers, paradise, in a seat of truth, that is paradise, near the omnipotent King, Allah, the All Blessed, the Most High, the Owner of Majesty and Honor. When he finished citing this, Allah took his soul. He had many students. 25 of them were prominent scholars, including two famous ones, Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyya, who lived between 691 up till 751 after Hijrah, and Ibn Kathir, the great scholar of Tafsir. He is one of Ibn Taymiyyah's students, who died in the year 774 after Hijrah. Also, he had many students that, amazingly, many of them were from India. Many scholars who studied in Damascus under Ibn Taymiyyah. Rahmatullahi alayhi. Ibn Taymiyyah received knowledge from more than 200 scholars in all disciplines of Islamic study. He excelled in fatawa when he was less than 19 years old. It did not take him too long before he began to write. His writings reached 500 volumes. His funeral took place in Damascus. Ibn Kathir wrote describing his funeral. قال Ibn Kathir في وصف جنازته. People closed their shops and all came except the weak. Those who could not attend resorted to dua, asking Allah's mercy upon him, and an estimated 15,000 women attended his funeral. Others were on the roofs of their buildings, all asking Allah's mercy upon him. All cried. Men attending the funeral were between 60,000 and 100,000. Other estimates reached 200,000. The funeral prayers were conducted at Bani Umayyah's mosque in Damascus. Many saw good dreams about him. May Allah's mercy be upon him. Ibn Taymiyyah was very knowledgeable about the doctrines of other religions. There where we are coming. He was very knowledgeable about the doctrines of other religions and philosophy. He wrote many treatises, rasa'il, about different religions and mystic sects, defending the oneness of Allah and proving that the true essence of religion revolves around the fact that Allah deserves to be worshipped alone, because God Allah is one and He is not contradictory. One of Ibn Taymiyyah's famous writings was in response to Christian claims that the Quran, Islam, and Prophet Muhammad ﷺ are only limited to the Arab
and that Islam condones and respects the Christian belief about Jesus, about Trinity, etc. هذه هي القصة التي سنأتي إليها لمداولتها إن شاء الله في هذه الدروس. وصل إلى يده رسالة كتبها أحد الأساقفة النصارى، وفي هذه الرسالة يجمع بكلام هذا الأسقف النصراني وهو راعي بطراركية صيدا في جنوب لبنان ذاك الوقت. هذا الرجل قابل علماء النصارى كثير من روميا إلى صقلية إلى كثير من بلاد العالم، وأراد أن يعرف موقف أكابر القوم من دين الإسلام هذا الأسقف، لأنه كان يواجه كثير من هذه الأسئلة. This bishop who wrote this letter was the bishop of the church of Sidon, which is in south Lebanon, 25 miles south of Beirut, which is around 40 kilometers. And this one was a scholar who wanted to know the position of his learned Christians about Islam and about Quran, about Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he traveled in many places. He met in Sicily, in Rome, in many other places. He met learned scholars of the Christian faith. And he asked them questions, what is their position towards this man called Muhammad, peace be upon him. And he came with the al-zibda, the conclusion, that, as Ibn Taymiyyah said, that this deen, this Islam, is only limited to the Arabs. انتبه انه هذا الاسلام مختص بمن؟ العرب، اهل الجزيرة. ثانيا ان القرآن يدعم اقوال النصارى بان المسيح هو ما هو عليه بالنسبة اليه. وثالثا ان مفهوم التوحيد عند المسلمين ليس ببعيد عن مفهوم التثليث عندهم. هذه أمور ناقشها هذا الأسقف، وكتب هذه الرسالة إلى عموم النصارى في ذلك الوقت، وكثير منها يدندن حولها النصارى في أيامنا هذه. فابن تيمية وصلت إليه هذه الرسالة فكتب كتابه المشهور الجواب الصحيح لمن بدل دين المسيح، الجواب الصحيح لمن بدل دين المسيح. For his response came in a book, and the title was Al-Jawab al-Sahih liman badala deen al-Masih, which the translation of the meaning is the correct response to those who altered the religion of Jesus. The book was first published by Dar al-Kutub al-Masriya. أول ما طبعته Dar al-Kutub al-Masriya. And recently, however, a group of reviewers, Dr. Ali bin Hassan bin Nasser and Dr. Abdul Aziz bin Ibrahim al-Askar and Dr. Hamad bin Muhammad al-Hamdan, found and amended four manuscripts, two of them in Istanbul dated 861 after Hijrah, which is 1483, and 1094 after Hijrah, which is 1683 in the Christian era respectively. The third manuscript was found in the library of the University of Leiden in Holland, and dated 730 after Hijrah, which corresponds to 1330 in the Christian era. And the fourth manuscript was found in Cairo, dating to 1281 after Hijrah, which is 1864 in the Christian era. After full amendation of all available manuscripts, printed and in manuscript form, the book was published in six volumes in Arabic by Dar al-Asima in Riyadh in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia in the year 1414 after Hijrah. In an attempt to provide us with the issues discussed by Ibn Taymiyyah about his response, about Christianity and other religions that contradict the essence of Tawheed, this will be, inshallah, the topic that I will deal with during these few days with you. I think we should stop here because of the time for the prayer, inshallah, and then we will resume shortly after that, bi-ibnillah.
محاضرة في العصر ومحاضرة بعد المغرب ومحاضرة بعد العشاء. وقد حرصنا على أن نستضيف في هذه الدورة عددا ممن لهم تجاوز وممن لهم باع وخبرة في هذا المجال، فوفقنا بفضل الله تبارك وتعالى إلى استضافة فضيلة الشيخ الدكتور صالح الصالح، وهو رئيس قسم الترجمة في مركز توعية الجاليات القصيم، وهو داعية مارس هذه الدعوة عددا من السنين وفترات طويلة في الخارج وفي الداخل، ولديه الكثير من الخبرات التي يستطيع أن يقدمها لنا ويفيدنا من خلال هذه المحاضرة. ورغبة منا في إكمال وإتمام الفائدة وحرصا على تنويع المعلومات، فقد وفقنا كذلك بفضل الله تبارك وتعالى في استضافة أو في دعوة أحد الدعاة المبرزين في منطقة الرياض، وهو الشيخ حذيفة عبد الرحيم، وهو داعية أيضا أمريكي، وقد مارس الدعوة كثيرا، وسوف يصل غدا إن شاء الله ربما في المساء، ولعله يباشر المحاضرات مع بداية يوم الاثنين إن شاء الله تعالى. فكما أسلفنا أن هذه المحاضرات ستكون على ثلاث فترات، وكما هو ملاحظ لكم في الجداول التي وزعت عليكم قبل قليل، فالمحاضرات ستتركز حول الدعوة إلى الله، وسيقوم المحاضر بإعداد عناصر المحاضرة، ومن ثم يتم تصويرها وتوزيعها عليكم حتى يسهل عليكم مراجعتها والاطلاع عليها، وليكون ذلك أثبت في المعلومة. ثم من المفترض أن يكون في نهاية الدورة اختبار حتى يبين ويكشف مدى التحصيل العلمي الذي حققه الدارس من خلال حضوره في هذه المحاضرات. فسيتم إن شاء الله إعداد امتحان في نهاية هذه الدورة. قضية أخرى أود الإشارة إليها، وهي أن هذه الدورات القصيرة تتطلب جدية وتتطلب حرصا ومواظبة على الحضور، ولهذا من الخطأ أن يفرط أحدنا في الحضور أو بالتأخير، فإنه ربما يضيع عليك فائدة، في حين أن هذه الدورات هي قليلة ونادرة من نوعها، فينبغي أن نغتنم هذه الفرصة. وسيكون النظام في هذه الدورة سيتم التحضير، تحضير الأسماء مع بداية كل محاضرة، مع بداية المحاضرة تتحضر الأسماء، وفي حالة يعني إذا تكرر الغياب من البعض أكثر من مرتين أو ثلاث بدون مبرر واضح، فإننا نستبيح عذرا أن نبعد اسمه عن الدورة، لأنه يجب أن نترك المجال لمن يريد أن ينتظم ويواظب في هذه الدورة ويحصل الفائدة المرجوة. وأختم الحديث حتى لا أطيل عليكم، وأترك المجال لفضيلة الشيخ ليطلعنا على ما عنده وعلى منهجه في هذه الدورة. أذكركم جميعا، ويحسن بنا ونحن في هذا المقام أن نتذكر قول الله تعالى في آخر سورة يوسف عليه السلام، الآية العظيمة التي هي التي رسمت منهج الدعوة إلى الله، قول الله تعالى: قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني. والآية خطاب موجه للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وللأمة من ورائه، فالدعوة هي سبيل الأنبياء وهي سبيل أتباع الأنبياء كذلك. والشاهد من هذه الآية هي قوله تعالى على بصيرة وغير خاف عليكم ما ذكره أهل العلم في هذه الآية، وإنما أردت التنويه والإشارة إلى ما ورد في هذه الآية من فوائد، وإلا فإنه من المعلوم أنها لا تخفى عليكم ولا تخفى على أمثالكم، وأنتم قد قدمتم برغبتكم في تلقي هذه العلوم ولممارسة هذه الأنشطة والمجالات. قال العلماء على بصيرة أي بصيرة بالمدعو إليه، فيجب على الداعية إلى الله أن يكون على علم وعلى بصيرة وأن لا يدعو بجهل، فالجاهل ربما يفسد أكثر مما يصلح، وربما يدعو إلى بدعة، وربما دعا إلى ضلال، فينبغي أن تكون عالما بالأحكام وبالأمور التي تدعو إليها، وكما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغوا عني ولو آية. ولا يلزم أن تحيط بالعلوم وأن تحيط بجميع الآيات وبجميع الأحاديث وبجميع الكتب وبجميع السنن، هذا غير لازم، وإنما إذا أردت أن تدعو إلى جزئية أو إلى مسألة صغيرة ينبغي أن تكون مطلعا على أقوال العلماء في هذه المسألة حتى لا تزل بك القدم ولا تخطئ السبيل والطريق. ثم البصيرة يجب أن تكون على بصيرة بحال المدعو، ويستدل أهل العلم على هذه الفائدة بقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لمعاذ بن جبل عندما بعثه إلى اليمن، قال له إنك تأتي أهل كتاب، فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لمعاذ إنك تأتي أهل كتاب، فأخبره أنهم أهل كتاب حتى يستعد لمجادلتهم وحتى يعلم حالهم ويعرف ماذا يقول لهم، فإنك ربما إذا جادلت من لا تعرف حاله ربما غلبك بالحجة حتى وإن كان الحق معك. ويدل على هذا قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لعل أحدكم يكون ألحن من الآخر حجة فأقضي له بحق أخيه. فالإنسان حتى وإن كان الحق معه ربما لا يستطيع أن يدلل وأن يثبت ويبرهن على الحق، فينهزم أمام الخصم أو أمام المجادل، وحينئذ بالتالي تكون الهزيمة ليست لذاتك، وإنما الهزيمة للحق الذي تحمله، وإنما الهزيمة للدعوة وللحق الذي يحمله هذا الداعي إلى الله. فينبغي أن تكون على علم وعلى بصيرة. ثم البصيرة والفائدة الثالثة والأخيرة التي تستنبط من هذه الآية أن تكون حكيما في الدعوة إلى الله. إن الدعوة هي بحاجة إلى حكمة، والحكمة لا يفهم أنها الضعف، فكثير من الناس يفهمون أن الحكمة هي الضعف واللين دائما، أن الحكمة هي وضع الشيء في موضع كما قال العلماء، فالشدة في موضع الشدة واللين في موضع اللين، ومن الردى أو من الخطأ وضع الندى في موضع السيف، أو كما قال الشاعر خطأ أن الإنسان يكون لينا وحليما في مواضع تنتهك فيها حرمات الله وينبغي أن يكون حازما شديدا، بل يجب أن تكون حكيما وأن تدرك المصالح والمفاسد. وأقتصر على قصة واحدة وكلكم يعرفها ولكن من باب التذكير، وهي قصة الأعرابي الذي دخل على المسجد في مسجد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فبال هذا الأعرابي في طائفة من المسجد، فغضب الصحابة رضي الله عنهم، وقد كانوا أشد الناس غيرة على الدين بعد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فغضبوا غضبا شديدا ونهروه وزجروه، فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تنهروه أو لا تجرموه، فقضى الأعرابي بوله، وبعد أن فرغ دعاه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأخبره بأن المساجد لا يجوز أن يحدث الإنسان فيها أو يقضي حاجته فيها. فحتى أنه قيل أن هذا الأعرابي قال اللهم اغفر لي ولمحمد ولا تغفر لأحد معنا أو ولا تغفر معنا لأحد. وكما نقل عن هذا الأعرابي نظرا لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تعامل معه بحلم ورفق وروية. قال تعالى وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. وفي نفس الوقت نجد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في مواضع الغضب والشدة يكون حازما. فعندما قيل له أن ابن جميل منع الزكاة قال ما ينقم ابن جميل أن كان فقيرا فأغناه الله. فشدد عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ووبخه وعنفه لأن الأمر يستدعي الشدة. وعلى كل حال الحديث يطول في هذا الباب، ونسأل الله عز وجل أن ينفعنا وإياكم بهذه الدورة وأن يجعلها في ميزان حسناتكم جميعا، وأن يوفق فضيلة الشيخ لإلقاء ليلقي عليكم ما في جعبته من معلومات وأن نستفيد منها بإذنه تعالى. وأترك المجال بعد أن نستعرض أسماء الحضور. يا سمحت يا شيخ حضر. الأخ أسامة نجيب. نعم. الأخ محمد السيد عبد العال. الأخ محمد السيد عبد العال. الأخ إبراهيم صالح العديل. علاء الدين أبو لذيذ. الأخ يوسف عبد العزيز الطريفي. الأخ محمد عبد القوي. محمد عبد القوي. هشام محمد عبد الفتاح. مرضي خاتم. أخ أكمل خان. أكمل خان. عبد العزيز الحسين. عبد الحميد عبد الرؤوف محمد. سلامة فهد السلامة. سعود الحمام. أحمد المطوع. فهد العقلة. عبد الرحمن العديد. بدوي صيرحي. كمال بابكر. ضاحي السكيبي. أخ ضاحي السكيبي. عادل صالح البكر. أخ نهار خلص الشمري. محمد خلص. أخ رفيق علي الشريف. رفيق. أخ عايد سيد الهمزاني. أخ عبد اللطيف أبو بكر. أخ فلاح محمد. لماش أو لماش. أخ محمد إبراهيم. إبراهيم. أخ أيمن طاهر. أخ محمد نصير أو نصير. عبد الله فهد الواحد. محمد إقبال رشيد. سالم زيد وير. محمود سالم التميمي. محمد حسن عثمان. مصطفى علي. مصطفى علي. مسعود أبو الخلف. مسعود. محمد يوسف أبو العلاء. فهد قادم القاضي الشمري. حمدي توفيق حسين بكر احمد سلامه سهيل ايوب حسام الدين هاشمي محمد عالم حسان محمد محمد مجدي محمد عبد الله النامي محمود محمد عطية محمد زمنو محمد زافرة عبد الكريم إبراهيم علي حسان الجميل ناصر حسان الجميل طيب جزاكم الله خير. نترك الفرصة الآن عبد الرحمن مرزا في أحد إخوان ناس معنا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. All praise is due to Allah. We praise him and seek his help and forgiveness. And we seek refuge in Allah alone. He is most high. We seek refuge in him from the evils of our own self and from our own wicked deeds. Whomsoever has been guided by Allah, none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah misguides, none can guide him. I bear witness that there is no true God worthy of being worshipped except Allah. He has no partner or associate. I further bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his slave and messenger. May Allah the Exalted bestow his peace and blessings on the final Prophet Muhammad, upon his good and pure family, and upon all of his noble companions. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. The translation of the meaning, O you who believe, fear Allah. And how to fear Allah?
By doing all that he ordered us to do, and on abstaining from everything that he commanded us not to do. Fear him as he should be feared, and die not except on Islam, on submission to him. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. The translation of the meaning: O mankind, be beautiful to your Rabb. And listen carefully, please. I will use the word Rabb, which is the proper translation of the meaning, as it should be, Rabb, not Lord. Because Lord is the one which is used by Christians to donate or denote Jesus alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam. So be careful. Try always to use the word Rabb and understand its meaning when you deliver any talk or you deal with someone. What does the word Rabb mean? Rabb, Allah first is the Rabb. He is the one who gave all things the power to grow and to move and to change. To whom belongs creation and commandment. He is the master who has no equal in his sovereignty, predominance and highness. The one who provides and sustains all that exists. This is the meaning of Ar-Rabb. O mankind, be dutiful to your Rabb Allah, who created you from a single soul, and from it created its mate, and from them both scattered many men and women. And fear Allah, through whom you demand your mutual right, and not to cut the relations of the womb, the kinship. Surely Allah is ever a watcher over you. This is in Surah An-Nisa, chapter 4, ayah 1, verse 1. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. The translation of the meaning: O you who believe, keep your duty to Allah and speak always the truth. He will direct you to do good deeds and will forgive you your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he verily has got a great success. Surah Al-Ahzab, the Quran, Surah 33, Ayah 70 and 71. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. It proceeds then that the most truthful speech is that of Allah's book, the Quran, and that the best of guidance is that of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the worst of evils are innovations, not cars, not computers. Innovations are the foreign teachings that are not part of Islam. And the worst of evils are innovations foreign to the true teachings of Islam. And every innovation in religion is a bid'ah. And every bid'ah is a dalala, misguidance, deviation. And that dalala is in hell. I had in mind certain things to say according to the discussions that we hope, inshallah, to complete during these few days with you. But listening to my brother Ahmed in his introduction, I wrote a note here which hopefully will help me, if not today, maybe tomorrow or the day after, inshallah. And the question I put to myself is to ask you this: what are the main points that you feel you need to have in order to call someone to Islam? Is there a feeling within you that you lack certain things? Is there a hesitation that you find within yourself? يعني هل يكون عندك تردد احيانا حين تريد ان تدعو انسان الى الاسلام؟ تخوف، توقع انه يسألك سؤال تعجز عنه. كل هذه الامور, all these things, a question that he may raise that will put you out of balance. So I throw this question upon you and let us hear some answers from you, and we'll try to have a mutual discussion here before I go ahead with what I have planned. So anybody wants to tell something that he feels, whether it's hesitation, whether it's a lack of knowledge, etc. How do I proceed? What is the best way, etc. I mean, please get these things out. If anybody wants to start, he may inshallah raise his hand and try to say whatever he feels. تفضل يا اخو البحر. طيب تفضل. The way, the best way. طيب غير هذا اخو سعود تفضل. تردد. Proper. Yeah, you try to find. نعم. طيب. أخوان
شيخ.
His background. No.
But sometimes we know enough about Christians.
No. But other. No. طيب. أخونا في اللغة. أيوة language barrier, يعني في حاجز اللغة. طيب. طيب. جزاك الله خير. Language barrier. طيب. أيضا.
Most of what we say we discuss from the point of view of that person and the coming to Islam. But isn't it true that the coming to
Islam? Allah Sallam.
Is that lay the ground for Islam from that point of attack? Is not attack that issue from that point? He merely said, you guys want and you should obey. Isn't that, you know, that the way that we should unify the
point? Tawheed. Sayyid, that's right. Huna, Al-Yamid.
One thing, talking about the point
of ماذا يعني ما يثيرونه حول الإسلام الآن يعني؟ طيب. يعني الشبهات فقط. أحسن. طيب. Doubts about Islam. Try to confuse people. نعم. Good behavior. طيب. طيب. أخونا. Fear. The atmosphere. نعم. Like Abu Saud. نعم. Like the proper timing, when it is appropriate now, not appropriate. Is that what you mean? نعم. When it is suitable, when it is fitting, right? طيب غير هذا. العلم. العلم هو اللي هو يعني يولد ثقة بالنفس أو عدم الثقة بالنفس. يعني knowledge. Do I have knowledge or not? If I want to say something, then it must be based on knowledge, or else I am going to say upon Allah things which Allah did not say, and I am going to be under warning, severe warning from Allah. Shameful. This is called self-defeat. Self-defeat. Inhizam nafsi. Huh? Inferiority complex. Izdiwajiyat. Inferiority. Subhanallah. غير هذا. Anything else? طيب ان شاء الله
تفضل.
ماري لاك اوف نوليدج. طيب نعم لا الحمد لله خلاص ننهي ان شاء الله هنا لان هذه هي لب التي تجمع كل الامور التي تكلمتم حولها. We end here because this is the point where everything converges to. That is the issue of knowledge. Knowledge how to, knowledge of what I'm going to give this person, having some knowledge about his background, general knowledge perhaps, not to, you know, be a scholar about his religion, you know, that's left for some people who want to specialize. But we are talking about the general da'wah, the general da'wah, so that everybody will be able, inshallah, to give it. طيب لذلك الآن نعرف, that's why we now know the emphasis which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given in the Quran when he addressed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the ayah, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ. And know that there is no true God worthy of being worshipped except Allah and seek forgiveness for your own sin. This is the issue. فَعْلَمْ يَا مُحَمَّدْ. Know what? That there is no true God worthy of being worshipped. This means this is the essence of the da'wah. So we're trying to focus the situation here. What is the essence of the da'wah? And what is the purpose of calling people to? Is to verify to them, number one, that there is no true God worthy of being worshipped except Allah. This is the issue between us and mankind who are not believers in Allah. Whether they are Buddhas, Hindus, Christians, Jews, etc. This is the fulcrum, this is the point, this is the start and this is the end. All the other issues revolve around this. So this means that the da'iyah to Allah should not run around the bushes. يعني ما يدور حول الغابة يعني من يمين وشمال إلى آخره. Address the issue which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم put it as a title in his call to the kings and to the Kisras of the Persians and to the non-Muslims and to the Najashi and to others at his time. This is the issue that there is no true God who deserves to be worshipped except Allah. Now, whether it will be during the means for that may vary depending on the situation itself. If you don't have the proper time this day, maybe try to find, create the atmosphere, quote unquote, whereby you may hint towards the discussion with this person. يعني حاول أنك تجد الجو الملائم وتجد أن هذه الساعة مناسبة أكثر, هذه أفضل إلى آخره. This is better timing, this is not a better timing. These are what is called means. But what we are always, what we are going to concentrate on is the issue itself, and that is the issue of knowledge. العلم. طيب لماذا العلم؟ لأن هذا العلم هو سبيل الأنبياء. This is the way of the prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen from mankind those respected and honorable people and sent them delegates to his creation since Adam alayhi salam and then to mankind by the final prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, calling their respective nations and the past to the same message. And their message was laid on two foundations. Number one, العلم, والثاني العدل. Knowledge and justice. This is the way of the Prophet. As Shaykh al-Islam Ahmad bin Ibn Taymiyyah had verified this during his extensive studies of the life of the Prophets and their da'wah. Two important issues, knowledge and justice. I have now, I want to tell you now the main scope of my discussions that are going to be held in these talks inshallah. I mentioned the name Ahmad ibn Taymiyyah and I said Shaykh al-Islam. Some people may have not heard of the name, some people may have heard of the name. Many in the Muslim world have heard about Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and about his works that are mostly in Arabic, and some are translated to Urdu, I believe. But still, the majority of his books are not translated into many languages. But the beginning of the translation, or this translation, is beginning to manifest itself nowadays. His discussions of da'wah are so important to our discussions now because of his extensive knowledge. They are extremely important, as I said, because of his extensive and comprehensive understanding of, number one, Islam. If I don't know Islam, then what I am going to give? فَاقِدُ الشَّيْءِ لَا يُعْطِيهِ. The person who doesn't know about his faith, about Islam, is not going to be able to give anything to anyone. So that's the knowledge in Islam which the brothers have concentrated during their answering. Now, he extracted his evidences not from sheer logic. No, because as my brother before me, when he spoke, he told you that if you concentrate on the issue through sheer logic and reasoning, my reasoning could be stronger than yours, and yours could be stronger than mine. Therefore, the ayah which I am trying to give to you, according to the way of my reasoning, may be defeated by your own reasoning. You see? So I'll put the Quran under the test of your reasoning and my reasoning. Okay, this doesn't mean excluding reasoning. Don't forget, don't for any misunderstanding. But it has its way. As you will understand, inshallah, during the course of this discussion. He laid his, or he extracted his understanding of Islam from the two main sources, the Quran and the Sunnah, which is the way, practice, recommendation, behavior, and all the practices of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that were inspired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and related to Islam. This is the meaning of Sunnah. But Quran and Sunnah, everybody says Quran and Sunnah, everybody says Quran and Sunnah every day. Quran and Sunnah according, and this is the criteria, according to Sabeel al-Mu'mineen. Do you imagine in your life, don't you imagine in your life that Allah, you love Allah to be pleased with you? Every one of us wants Allah to be pleased with him. We know when we read the Quran that already there are people whom Allah was pleased with, and they were pleased with him. And who are they? Who are they? من هم؟ من هم الذين نقرأ عنهم في كتاب الله أن الله سبحانه وتعالى تخيل هذه أنت أن الله سبحانه وتعالى رضي عن بشر وأعلن رضاؤه عنهم في كتاب يتلى إلى يوم القيامة. من هم؟ المؤمنين أتباع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذين هم صحابته والذين اتبعوهم بإحسان. And those who follow their path. Why? Because they were the ones who accommodated the understanding and the practice of this deen more than anyone else after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they are the criteria, which means that they are the reference in understanding the Quran and Sunnah. They are our reference. So he extracted his evidences from the Quran and Sunnah as understood by the all are called as-salaf as-salih, the righteous predecessors. Min salafina as-salih. Anyone who follows their path is considered to be from the Salaf, although he is living now, meaning that he followed the understanding of this deen in accordance with the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ibn Taymiyyah, the renowned scholar of Islam, was born in the year 661 after Hijrah, which corresponds to, if you want to write those down, this information, please write it down, don't hesitate. He was born in the year 661 after the Hijrah, after the migration of the Prophet ﷺ from Mecca to Medina, which represents the Islamic calendar, which corresponds to the year 1263 in the Christian era. Have you seen when you read some books and they relate dates to the Christian era, they write 1995 AD, A, Pop D. Have you seen that? Please don't use it, and this is why.